Now these are the three courses basically we will be talking about now. So level 1 is nursery, level 2 is junior KG and level 3 is senior KG. In junior KG we don't do alphabetically. We will do as per it is easy to write. So we'll do LT and all that. So we'll follow the sequence. Yeah. So junior KG the sequence is that.
Yeah. So now the children of ours, they have already done the nursery when it was online. So they are not, you know, well versed with the rhyming words and all.
Yeah,
so
that we will do.
Okay.
See, in junior KG, the basic requirement is recognition of letters.
Correct.
Both capital and small. If they can recognize well, no, it's very easy to go to take them ahead.
Right.
If recognition is not there, no, then it is very difficult for me. Because what we do, if you are doing two sums, suppose I have done LTI, so I will do IT8 there only.
Correct.
So if they can't recognize, no, then it becomes.
Recognition is done, but for my son, I would be, you know, giving him honest feedback that he can recognize the alphabet with the uppercase. Lowercase, he gets confused at times.
See, BB confusion, P, G, J, L, turns right or left, confusion is there till first, second standard. So that's not an issue. But at least when I say M or M, they should be able to write. One jump, two jump confusion is okay. But at least the jump is there. That utna bhi clear hai, but then it is fine. Then I can go ahead smoothly. Then I don't have to, you know, put too much into it. And of course, we will be doing recognition. We'll do flashcards and everything. But it goes little smoother for me. So we will be doing in the way we write the letters and then with that we will be doing two letter words. So junior KG we do sounds, vowels in the word. So I told you like it. So we'll do what are vowels. Vowels actually we finish in nursery and say these are the five vowels. So then we do the words. To understand what they should know what are vowels. So we'll do two letter words, we'll do three letter words. Vocabulary in the sense that when we are doing three letter word, so cat, so what is cat? So, jitne bhi word we will do, they know what the meaning of those words are, except few which they are too young to know. So, a majority of the words they will know. And then we will do reading, writing sentences and sight words. Three letter sight words we will do. Majority of the three letter sight words. And a few four letter also we have done. There is that, what jo very common, all those we will do. And reading, writing, by the end of the year in junior KG, they write their own three letter word sentence. That is our milestone which we very easily achieve. So my present year also they are doing. And then different in names and sound. So when I say L, they should understand it is the name of a letter. When I say L, they should understand it is the sound of the letter. Even now when I tell them to say a spelling, no, they will say b-i-t-a. Then b-i-t-a is wrong. It should be b-i-t-a or you say b-i-t. Either you say all the sounds or you say all the letters. This is the thumb rule, basic rule that they should follow. And it is while even doing homework, you should follow. Either say all the sounds or say all the letters. But read in only one format. Don't mix up the two, otherwise the sound will go wrong. Sight words you have to say only letters. Which way you don't have to say sounds. Sight words will only be done by the letters.
Shouldn't the
kids
get confusion where and what?
Initially they.
Indication
yadi. Haan, W-H-E-R and W-E-R.
She just meant the dash and kinta.
There, haan, few
words are tricky.
Our, O-U-R and A-R-E. There, E-I-E-R.
Even in R, I was clarifying.
And all this we do by flashcard, games, books, worksheets and videos. So even I have games for each topic of the phoning. So we all usually play games, we play other games also than phoning games. So it's like a, you know, reward to them whoever finishes first 10 games.
Right, right. If they write the
time. Yes, if they are not doing the homework, at that time they will do the homework and others we play. So this is also one thing, finish their homework today. This is the rule. Then like at that time they are not playing the topic game, they are playing some other game which it's okay if the other child is not playing. But they will learn that they have to finish their homework if they have to play them.
Yeah.
Then we play many random games also, you know, like color, they are lover. If I tell a color, if they touch it, whoever touched first is okay. Whoever not touching wrong or touched last have to say a spelling. So that any game I relate to what we are doing now. If we used to do the days of the week, so Tuesday, Wednesday. So I know which child ka, what is the weak point. So that child has to say that spelling.
Thursday.
Yeah.
Next next mistake is
Thursday. Yeah. So all that we do with a plain way method. That is. So now this is basically junior KG. So the main criteria what I focus on in junior KG is recognition sound anywhere in the world. It could be beginning sound, it could be in the middle, or it could be in the ending sound. So when I say suppose tiger, so R is at the end. So you have to sometimes write the ending sound, sometimes beginning sound. So basically, this sound is where in that word. So it could be anywhere in the word. Differentiate between consonant and vowels. And then introduction of words. So here we start with, I told you, two letters, three letters, I just explained you. So we will do alphabets, and then whenever we have finished those alphabets, we will do that two letter word. We have done E in the beginning, if you have done W now, so we will do WEB. So by the Diwali, like first 6 months, we finish all the sounds, writing of all the 26 alphabets and all the two letter words. After Diwali, we start the three letter word families, their sentences, comprehension, everything to do. So this is the actual, the way it is divided. CEC word, importance and use of vowels in the words. So we will do all A vowel first, then I vowel. So we will go in that sequence. And then meaning of the words, I told you, the pictures and everything, because they should know what they are writing. And even when they have to make sentence, if they don't know the meaning, I mean, if they don't know what is rare, it is difficult for them to make a sentence. So that is the main criteria. Usage of the words in meaningful sentences and difference between question and answer. So for this, I give them question, they have to trace answer and then they copy the answer. So that they understand this is a question and this is the answer. And even jumbled sentences are there, like words are there, they have to frame it in sentence. Oh. So all this is done in junior KG. So this is a basic curriculum of the junior KG. Recognition, sequence, phonic sound, beginning, ending, vocabulary with that sound, writing both cases together, vowels and consonant, vowel sound, sounds in words, then two letter, three letter side word. And this is a bit of grammar that we do. Opposite sentences, comprehension and word search. So all the three letter words sometimes they have to find in the word search.
You can enjoy
that. That today also last year everyone is so happy with that.
Favorite. First find that only.
And then we have stories. What I told about nursery, that picture talk we also in junior KG. So but in a depth, and then I ask them question and they have to answer in sentences in junior KG. Then five sentences of on a topic and festival conversation. Now what happens that whenever anything you want to introduce to a child, it is always done with oral first, then they can write. So in senior KG, the five sentences that we write on a topic are orally done in junior KG. So it is always a step ahead. So we do the festivals, all the topics that you can write, picture talk, all the topics, five sentences on each we are doing in orally in junior KG. Then all this we do by revision every day. When they come first, I revise what I have done and then we start the new thing. Worksheet, dictation is very important in junior KG. Two letter, three letter, once I finish a family, we'll do dictation. So that will be there. And correction five times, they have to do it, otherwise it is very difficult. Homework, now homework may, in the worksheet itself, they'll be homework. These are new, so I'm just explaining a little bit. We will do few sheets we'll only do half, and few sheets we'll do orally or mark the answer, whatever, but that word they have to write in the blank for homework. So it say, there are two benefits. It says my time in the class, each child writes in a different way. Each child's formation of a letter in each school has a different formation. So then it is difficult for me. So it saves my time. And secondly, when they write for homework, it's revised. So it is your duty that when you make them to sit right, ask them to read first and then write. So whichever worksheet is for homework, you have to read them first before writing. So the homework will be there in the notebook for sure. All the families and work we are doing, they have to write. And there will be homework in the worksheet. I will write HW on that page. So you have to go through the whole set of worksheets that you are getting to know which page is a homework. And in junior day, you might get some coloring homework and all. If that homework is not done, it's okay. But writing homework, they have to do. Okay? Then games, reading books, and flashcards and videos. So it is there for each sound and everything.